talking about the financial services space, there is this transaction that's just got announced. 2.2% is what Premji Invest is investing, putting in. It has bought a 2.2% stake in the Aditya Birla Capital company, even before it is a separately listed company, which pegs the valuation of the company at about 32,000 crore rupees. What are those factors which has led to this kind of a valuation for this company?
These are all very high quality books, yes. Hardly any NPAs, less than 0.0% some percent. The fact that each of these businesses is a leader in that particular space of the financial services, plethora of businesses. Yes. I think it's all of those put together that gives it the kind of valuation that it's getting.
And fundraising was really not required for the company in terms of 2.2% that has been sold, 700 crores that has come into the company. But are you looking at further monetization as well of some of your businesses under?
So we are looking at monetization at the holdco level. So what we are listing or we're planning to list is really the holdco, and all the other businesses are part of the subsidiaries of the holdco, and that is something that's in the offing.
That is definitely part of the entire Grasim Novo merger process. But 17% in the Aditya Birla Capital company after listing would be held by the promoters, while 57% by Grasim. Now, is there any scope of monetizing that bit also by the promoters? Is that on the anvil?
So not at all. You know, we have great faith. I have great faith in this business. I have great faith in the management team of this business. And I think that what we are seeing now is perhaps just the tip of the iceberg in terms of the scale of these businesses and what they can do in terms of impact in each of those sectors. So no plans to monetize any of our stake.
And not even the companies, like, because life insurance companies are giving good valuations in the market, NBFC is giving good valuations.
No plan at all. I don't think there's any plan other than listing the holdco.
Mr. Birla, now, with the current setup and the way the entire group has transformed in the last 1 year with various deals, merger, and also tying up with Vodafone on the telecom side and Grasim Novo merger, and then a separate entity in terms of Aditya Birla Capital, is the financial services space going to be the next, you know, big growth area for Aditya Birla Group on the whole?
So we've been in this space for the last 20 years, and we've we've nurtured the space in the last 20 years, and this is the first time. Obviously, this is an IPO of our holding company, and absolutely, I think it is one of our most important businesses. It has been for a while. It's just that now that you know, it's going to get listed, perhaps will get much more attention than before.
So last 1 year has been very eventful for you, Mr. Birla. Is it going to be equally exciting the next year, or is it time to consolidate?
I think so. I think there are lots yet to be done. And one is constantly looking at opportunities to create more and more value.
All right. Thanks so much, Mr. Birla, for joining us on CNBC TV18. Thank you.